Some technologies are just plain exciting. A few minutes reading about AI, space travel, or nanomedicine can paint a dazzling picture of a not-too-distant future full of technological wonders. But if such a future is possible, it will likely owe less to space-age science fiction wizardry than it will to a technology which already exists. One that's been around for quite a while, which we use throughout our daily lives, and which might seem a little less exciting. Batteries. The modern importance of batteries is obvious. From talking teddy bears, to electric toothbrushes, to submarines, to the International Space Station, batteries enable huge parts of our world. And in electric cars, buses, and even planes, they're defining the next generation of transport. But perhaps the most important of these new roles is the storage of renewable energy. Because while wind and solar power solutions take huge strides forward each year, they do still have a pretty big drawback. The wind isn't always blowing, and the sun isn't always shining. But we need power 24 hours a day. Enter the Humble Battery. In 2017, Tesla won a $90 million contract to construct a power reserve at the Hornsdale Wind Farm in Australia. The result is a large plot of land covered with fridge-sized containers filled with battery cells, which store energy when surplus amounts are being generated by the wind farm and then release it into the power grid when supply is low. The project's success has spurred the development of similar facilities around the world as countries race to meet their commitments to clean energy. What's more, there are moves to replicate the idea on a household level, with Powerwall technologies being developed to store excess energy from rooftop solar panels for later use. The rise of these kinds of systems could represent a huge step in the efforts to decrease our dependence on fossil fuels. And they've only been made viable by recent technological advances. Battery performance has steadily improved in recent years, while the average cost of a battery kilowatt hour has fallen by an order of magnitude. And while this is great news, it doesn't necessarily represent a solution to all of our energy storage woes. One problem here is that as batteries become better and cheaper, we want more of them. Global battery demand is expected to triple between 2020 and 2025, and this demand is going to be increasingly hard to meet, especially to supply the level of energy storage required to power a country. But an even bigger issue is that battery cost really doesn't scale well. For devices with relatively low power demands, like your phone and laptop, batteries are a fairly affordable solution, costing at most a couple of $100s. Whereas a battery like the kind you'd find in an electric car will cost thousands of dollars, which is pretty expensive, if not prohibitively so. However, if we scale things up to the level of a national grid, things really start to fall apart. In 1 year, the US consumes almost 4,000 billion kilowatt hours, which means that at 2020 prices, the cost of powering the US for 1 day on batteries alone will be almost $1.5 trillion, or just over a third of the 2020 US federal budget. It's with these issues in mind that many people are beginning to look further afield for new energy storage solutions. And it turns out there are quite a few, because what's important to realize is that batteries only represent one form of energy storage. For example, around 95% of the world's current energy storage makes use of gravitational potential energy in a process known as pumped hydroelectric storage, or pumped hydro. Remember how at the Hornsdale Wind Farm, excess energy was stored in batteries? Well, in pumped hydro, that excess energy is used to pump water uphill, where it's stored in a reservoir. When more power is needed, the water is allowed to flow downhill, hence the word gravitational, powering turbines and generating electricity. This is a surprisingly simplistic and effective idea, though of course it isn't perfect either. It takes up lots of space, requires water access, and very specific geography. But the point is that thinking beyond batteries opens up a lot of new possibilities. Pumped hydro-inspired systems using cranes and concrete weights, systems which store energy as heat in carbon blocks, compressed air storage, cryogenic energy storage. These are all real projects pursuing alternative solutions to the same problem and demonstrating that energy storage is a diverse and constantly evolving field. And it needs to be, because it's impossible to ignore the extent to which we depend on energy and how this dependency will grow in the future. Whether we're talking about powering your latest handheld device, the future of clean transport, or the challenges of infrastructure-scale power grids, it's clear that in the coming years, energy storage is going to be an increasingly important topic. But it's essential we realize that there's no one-size-fits-all solution here. Batteries will continue to be essential to our everyday lives in many ways, but the conflict between our rising power usage and the need to accelerate our transition to sustainable energy leaves us with an energy storage void, one which batteries alone are unlikely to ever fill. Thank you.